नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, srimahans, mahans, tanidars, kotaris, visitors, viewers, every one of you sitting with us through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, RR TV, two-way video conferencing, and here in Bidhi campus. I welcome every one of you with my love and blessings. Today, the Vedic New Year, beginning of the Vedic New Year. Many states of India and Nepal, all of us celebrate the New Year celebration. Manmatha Nama Varsha, the year with the name of Manmatha Nama, means this year whatever you want will become reality. Manmatha is just achieving what you want as reality. Manmatha Nama Samvatsara Tamil New Year, in Kerala Malayalam New Year and Bengali New Year. Many states of Tamil Nadu, many states of India, sorry, many states of India follow this calendar. And Nepal also follow this calendar. So, my blessings to all of you on this auspicious occasion of Vedic New Year. Manmatha Nama Samvatsara New Year. Blessings to every one of you. Above all, today is also one more important day. Today is 14th anniversary of Nityananda Sangha. Actually, if you look the history back, Bidhi is not the first ashram I created. It's in Erode, on the banks of Kaveri, the place called Avattipalayam. That is the place the first ashram was created. Today, that ashram was formally inaugurated in 2001, April 14th. You can see the photograph with my own handwriting. Not to forget the date I myself recorded. In the name of Ramakrishna Dhyana Peetam, that was the first ashram I created on the banks of Kaveri in Erode. If you see, actually the Sangha, Nityananda Sangha, started on April 14th 2001. 2003 we became more an organization in Bangalore, Bidhi, but 2001 was the real beginning. I started my public life. It was 2001, April 14th. That was the morning. First, I tied the turban. After a long time, after my Parivirajaka, and realized the avataric mission, I was not able to tie the turban because the head will always feel heavy. Tying the turban was not possible. So it was April 14, 2001. I was settled into the body more comfortably and tied the turban and decided, come on, let's start. And 14 years over, 15th year beginning. Today is the same day we started the Ohio Adhinam also. Ohio Adhinam was also started on this very day. The Kumbhabhishekam of Nityanandeshwara Hindu Temple in Ohio was done. 8th anniversary of Nityanandeshwara Hindu Temple, Ohio Adhinam today. And they are offering 108 Naivedyam. I accept the offerings. I bless this Nityananda Sangha. Let you grow, grow, grow and serve the whole universe forever. Today is Nepali New Year also. So, blessings to Nepal Sangha, all the Nepali devotees. Mero Sapurna Nepali Bhaktajan Harulai Nayabarsha 2072 ko Hardik Mangalmaya Subhakamnara Ashirvad. All the devotees in Nepal, my blessings to all of you. Wishing a very, very happy New Year to all my Nepali devotees. And all the devotees in Tamil Nadu, தமிழகத்தில் தமிழ் உலகே தமிழகம் மாத்திரமின்றி உலகம் முழுவதும் இருக்கும் தமிழர்கள் அனைவருக்கும் எனது இனிய தமிழ் புத்தாண்டு நல்வாழ்த்துக்கள். மங்கள மன்மத வருடத்தில் சித்திரை நன்னாள் முதல் தேதியில் உங்கள் எல்லோருக்கும் எண்ணியதெல்லாம் எண்ணியாங்கு ஈடேறி திண்ணியராய் ஆனந்தமாய் நித்யானந்தராய் நித்யானந்தமயமாய் நித்யானந்தமாய் நீங்கள் எல்லோரும் வாழ்வீர்கள் என்று ஆசீர்வதிக்கின்றேன். இதே நாளில் 14 ஆண்டுகளுக்கு முன்பு உருவானது நமது நித்யானந்த சங்கம். பதினான்கு ஆண்டுகள் முடிந்து 15ஆம் ஆண்டிற்குள் அடியெடுத்து வைக்கிறோம். இந்த சங்கமும் சங்கம் சார்ந்த பக்தர்கள் சங்கத்தின் அங்கமான தங்கங்களான நீங்கள் எல்லோரும் ஆள்போல் தழைத்து அருகுபோல் வேரூன்றி மூங்கில் போல் சுற்றம் சூழ முக்காலத்தும் உலகிற்கெல்லாம் உண்மை தந்து நன்மை செய்து என்றென்றும் என் அன்னை மீனாட்சியின் திருவருளால். நித்யானந்தமாய் வாழ்ந்து நித்யானந்தத்தில் நிறைந்து நித்யானந்தமாய் இருப்பீர்களாக என்று முழுமையாக ஆசீர்வதிக்கிறேன். ஆனந்தமாக இருங்கள். மதுரை இஸ் ஆஃபரிங் 54 நிவேத்தியம்ஸ். அக்செப்ட் த நிவேத்தியம்ஸ், பிளெஸ்ஸிங்ஸ் அண்ட் வித் திஸ் New year, the season of celebration starts in the Vedic tradition. The season of celebrations. So get ready. From now, the season of celebration starts. Today, we also have some book release.
Nityanandam, on this auspicious occasion of the Vedic New Year and the 14th anniversary of the Nityananda Sangha, the Nityananda University Press has a very special release today. The Cosmic Truths, Akashic Records, read through Swamiji on the topics birth, death, life and beyond. Akashic Records are the mystical energy records.
Anandam anandam nityanandame, nityanandam anandam nityanandame, anandam anandam nityanandame, nityanandam anandam nityanandame, nityanandame nityanandame, govinda gopala keshava madhava narayana rajiva lochana adi sanadana nityanandam anandam anandam nityanandame, nityanandam anandam nityanandame.
Akashic records are the mystical energy records of all the events that have ever happened, are happening, and will happen in the cosmos. But the key to decode them is in the hands of a very few enlightened beings today. Now, Swamiji has opened up the Akashic records for the benefit of the entire humanity. This book includes a very powerful question and answer session where Swamiji reveals the cosmic truths about death to Inner Awakening participants in July 2014. Swamiji, thank you so much for releasing the first copy of this book with your blessings.
Today, Avati Palayam Ashram is also offering Annadan. My blessings for it to go well. Let's enter into today's satsang. I'll continue to expand on 8th verse of Isavasya Upanishad because there is so much to explore in that verse. Saparyaga chukramagayam avranam asnaviram sudhamabhava viddam kavirmanishi பரிபூ ஸ்வயம்பூர் யாதாதத்ய தோர்த்தான் வ்யததாஶ்சாஸ்வதீப்யஹ ஸமாப்யஹ. அல் read out the translation. Pure consciousness is all pervasive, beyond the coming and going, absolute, radiant and self effulgent, unembodied, boundaryless whole, beyond the subtle body, woundless, muscleless, having no incompletion with the body. Consciousness is the ever pure space devoid of the dirt of ignorance, and is untouched by the delusion of incompletion. Consciousness is the all-knowing seer of all, past, present and future, the lord of all minds, Manishi. Consciousness transcends all beings, Paribhu. Consciousness is self-existent by itself, with its independent will and intelligence, having no cause for its happening. It is pure consciousness that from time eternal has enriched the ages and each being by ordaining desirable responsibilities, artha, unto them as per their nature and space and their actions and results thereof. Today, the last line, we will work on this last line. It's pure consciousness that from the time eternal has enriched the ages and each being by ordaining desirable responsibilities, artha, unto them as per their nature and space and their actions and results thereof. So it is consciousness which is center of all your karma, akarma, vikarma. Your actions, the results, doing, non-doing, liberation from doing and non-doing, all this finally boils down to one, that is consciousness. You can achieve the space of non-doing, real non-doing, only by experiencing consciousness. You can achieve the space and achieve what you want by doing, only being the center of consciousness. Please understand, if you want to achieve what you want to achieve, you need to cognize you are consciousness. If you want to achieve the non-doing, you need to cognize you are consciousness. Whether you want to achieve something by doing or achieve non-doing, everything, the consciousness need to be centered. Sometime, my satsangs, means my words, look too small to express what I am feeling. My paper and pen looks too small, too little to express the poem inside me. The examples I am giving, the painting I am painting with the words, look too small compared to what I need to paint. Whether you want to achieve something or achieve non-doing, anything, the center is the cognition you are pure consciousness, because only that cognition can liberate you from time and help you to be in tune with time. Only that helps you to be in tune with time and liberates you from time. Only that enriches the time and the each being under the time. By ordaining desirable responsibilities, artha, unto them as per their nature and space and their actions and results thereof. Please understand. Ramana Maharishi beautifully says, Karmam payantaral kartanadanayar karmangada ulo undi vara. A beautiful jnana undiyar. There is a verse. Ramana Maharishi says, your actions give result because the Lord, the consciousness allows it, makes it happen, not because of karma itself. If the karma itself can directly bring result, then karma itself becomes God, which is not true. See, understand this example. You write a check for 1 lakh rupee and take it to the bank. Only when the manager releases the money, you get it. Because as a routine, you write the check and he gives, there is no stopping or blockage. You take it for granted, you start thinking, just by writing the check, you get the money. No, writing the check is your karma, means your action. But that brings result only when the manager says yes. Otherwise, he can stop, he can postpone, he can delay, he can deny. Yes, right to deny. Of course, then you have so many other legal recourse, that and all is different. But the action does not bring result in automated way. Even though things are made automatic for the sake of convenience, understand, in the cosmos also, even though things happen automatically for your convenience sake, don't ever assume the karma by itself can bring result, because karma is not Lord. Karmam payantaral kartanadanayal kanmam kadavulo undi vara. It is consciousness makes the result happen. It is the decision of consciousness makes the result happen. Actually, I feel I should not even put my hand on my heart when I explain the word consciousness. When I put that, all of you assume our consciousness is inside. No. I should just keep the word like hand like this. When I speak about consciousness, neither in nor out. It is. Or I should put the hand like this. Consciousness. Because sometimes what I express in the body language also should be in tune with the truth. Some people, when they utter the word consciousness, they should have the mudra of this. Scratching the head. For some people, it can be, they can show us in, some can show us out. But I can't show us in or out, it is just ease. Please understand, the lordship of consciousness is declared in this part of the Upanishad. It is consciousness from the time eternal has enriched the beings, ages and each beings, each being. By ordaining responsibilities desired by them, as per their nature and space, and their actions and results thereof. Lordship of the consciousness is revealed in this verse. It is pure consciousness that from time eternal has enriched the ages and each being. Please do Vakyarth Sadas on it today. this should be the subject of Vakyarth Sadas. Registrar should send this part as an email. Every day the Vakyarth Sadas topic should be sent as an email. Before starting the Vakyarth Sadas, you should read out the line. I specifically prescribe for Vakyarth Sadas. It should not be from your memory that is filled with too much of dirt. So, it should be directly from the statement of Upanishads. So listen, it is pure consciousness that from time eternal has enriched the ages and each being by ordaining desirable responsibilities unto them as per their nature and space and their actions and results thereof. Do Vakyartha Sadas on this line, discuss, debate, internalize. It is consciousness responsible for our nature, for the space, for our responsibilities, and our actions and results thereof. So surrendering to our consciousness, meditating on our consciousness can completely reprogram us. We can alter and change our life as we want. We can change our nature and space, our responsibilities and actions. We can change our results without even changing the nature and space. We can change the results without responsibilities. We can change the nature or without changing the space. Please understand all these responsibility, your nature, your space, your action, your result. All these are there. Responsibility, nature, space, and action and results. If you are working with any one of them, it has to change only systematically. Your responsibilities has to change, then your nature has to change, then your space has to change, then results will change. But if you work with consciousness, anything can be changed. Without changing anything, or everything can be changed. That is why you call what I am doing as miracles, because you know only one system of working. Responsibility changing, nature changing, space changing, results changing. But when I am working with you, you don't need to go through this. Line. You don't need to go through this cue, this rule. Consciousness can interfere into anything and directly change. Your responsibility might have been totally different. Your nature might have been totally different. Your space might have been totally different. Your actions might have been totally different. But the consciousness can change the result. Straight interfere and change the result. That is what you call as miracles. You feel, what? How can this be? My actions, everything was different. How suddenly the result is different? Consciousness has so much of freedom, power, because that is the center. around which everything moves. When you experience consciousness with your pure intelligence, you experience that as time. When you experience consciousness with your visualization capability, you experience that as a space. When you experience consciousness with your logic, you experience that as your nature. When you experience your consciousness with your desires, you experience that as a responsibility. When you taste your consciousness as a joy, you call that as a result. Meditate on this line. Meditate on this line, you will understand. An enlightened being can directly give you the joy through consciousness. That is why you feel the result of your life is achieved. That is why you feel life is a miracle. When you touch the consciousness and experience the consciousness. Consciousness. Meditate on this line, you will understand what I mean by this word. Your desires could have been different. Your responsibility could have been different. Your nature could have been different. Your space could have been different. Your actions could have been different. Results can just be different. That is why Mahadeva is able to initiate even a black sparrow and liberate. Enlightenment just for a few idlis, roadside idlis. But for Mahadeva's intervention, the one, the roadside idli seller can never achieve liberation. I am telling you, the intervention of consciousness is possible because consciousness is the center. That is the center. Constantly cognize your consciousness. You are not son of somebody. You are not father of somebody. You are not daughter of somebody. You are not wife of somebody. You are not brother of somebody. You are not son of somebody. You are not even disciple of somebody. Understand? Even I cannot corrupt you. Then who can corrupt you? You are pure consciousness. You can cherish your disciplehood, enjoy your discipleship, celebrate your discipleship as a nostalgia, as a sweet nostalgia. How I bow down to Mahadeva. How I fall flat in front of the deities in the temple. Just as nostalgia. In those days, when you came as Arunagiri Yogeshwara, how I enjoyed you. So I remember those beautiful vacation moments. Now I am bowing down to you. That's all. Nothing more. Actually, even Saiva Siddhanta is very clear. When I am reading more and more Agamas and Patadis, it is so clear. Shaiva Agamas are Advaita Agamas. It is the stupid fellows, few pundits, who are actually not even pandits, bandits. These stupid fellows, they missed. And they go on trying to fight. See, just they want something different. See this. Somehow this Saiva Siddhantis and Advaitis have a big incompletion, because all these Shankara Sampradaya fellows are always trying to put down the Siddhantis. Siddhantis always try to put down the Smarthas. This community problem, you should solve it in the community level. You can't bring that and force it on the philosophy and destroy the truth of the philosophy. These stupid fellows wanted to tell, claim something different from Advaita, because they feel if they accept Advaita, they become subordinate to Smarthas. Or if there is a community issue, solve it. Like a Thevar, Kounder, Mudaliyar. Don't bring that and impose it on the spiritual philosophy. Just because you need to tell something new, different. These fellows are saying that Siddhanta is duality. God is separate and you are separate. Today I declare, if I have experienced Mahadeva, if I am the embodiment and incarnation of Mahadeva, I will establish the truth of Saiva Siddhanta, the reality of Saiva Siddhanta, which is Suddhatvaita to the world again. It is Suddhatvaita. In Shaiva Agamas, there are Advaita Agamas and Dvaita Agamas, Dvaita Agamas declare God is separate, we are separate. Dvaita Agamas declare in the beginning God is separate, you are separate, but by the spiritual practice you and God become one. Advaita Agamas declare you and God are one from the beginning. Knowing this is spiritual practice. Suddhatvaita Agamas declare, even if you don't know, this is the reality. I tell you, Shaiva Siddhanta is Suddhatvaita Agama. Not even just Advaita Agama. It is Suddhatvaita Agama. I tell you, truth always empowers you. Reality always makes you powerful. Nothing can make you so powerful than pure Advaita. Dvaita can make you egoistic. Even in your surrender, you will have a humble ego, powerlessness will continue to rule you. Nothing like Advaita has a capacity to empower you. I tell you, that is reality. The action, result, nature, space, responsibility, everything is pure consciousness. Today, debate on this. do not remember the bandages from the body through the body as part of you. From the body means your disease, your concepts about body, feeling good or bad about the body, your skin color, everything. Through the body means feeling I am son of somebody, father of somebody, daughter of somebody, sister of somebody. Even disciple of somebody. No. I love Mahadeva just for the sake of love. That's all. Not bargaining, expecting tomorrow he will give me enlightenment. No. I already realized it. I already got it. In the course of my love, I had it. Now my love for him is only love for the sake of love. I just know he is me. All my aspirations are his aspirations. All my inspirations are his inspiration. All my desires are his desires. All my powers are his powers. Advaita bhakti. Bhakti established in Advaita. Understand? Even with Mahadeva, no question of duality. Then where is the question of duality comes with your family, parents, brother, sister, boss, subordinate? No. Do not entertain, cherish, engage yourself in the bondages from the body and through the body. Recognize your pure consciousness. When you recognize your pure consciousness and live your life, it becomes leela and drama. No incompletion will have place. No incompletion will have power over you. Your responsibility, your nature, your space, your desires, your actions, your results. If they go as per the law of the karma, it's life. Suddenly, it changes and brings the results which you never expected, which you feel bad for you. It's called accident. Suddenly it changes and brings the results which you never expected, but which you feel so good for you, it is miracle. An enlightened being can interfere into that cycle and change as they want because everything is centered on consciousness. Everything is centered on consciousness. You do yoga, you work out, you run, you do all the things required, and then health comes. It's the karma bringing result. But suddenly master puts his hand on your head and the health happens. Is consciousness interfering and creating a result which is independent of your nature, space, action and responsibility? That is what is initiation. Understand, in every being, only if an intervention of the consciousness happens, the ball starts rolling in a new direction and the progress towards the enlightenment will start happening. You can never ever reach the ultimate just by flowing through the law of karma. When will you reach? It's only by the intervention, by the spiritual intervention and conscious intervention, the results can change. You can reach enlightenment. Come to Varanasi to experience that intervention. I invite every one of you to be in Varanasi to experience that intervention. The conscious intervention causing miracles. Changing the results independent of action and space, responsibility and nature. Somewhere this karma chakra need to be broken and you need to be given a new energy, inspiration. Understanding and possibility. If you are always stuck with this action result cycle, you will never ever be given a chance to taste the possibility. Possibility, the taste of possibility can be given to you only when the divine intervention happens. Mahadeva intervenes in your life in the form of the master. He assumes the form of the master just to liberate people from the karma chakra, give inspiration, joy, bliss and cause miracles and enlightenment. Come to Varanasi to liberate yourself from karma videha bhumi, going beyond the karma and going beyond the bondages of the body. Jivan mukti kshetra. In tradition, it says any sannyasi should not stay in any place more than 3 days. But Varanasi is exempted. Somebody asked, why? Why Varanasi is exempted? You can stay any number of days in Varanasi. Because Varanasi, once in 3 days, the city will change. You will see once in 3 days, completely new scenes. Different atmosphere. New people. Because the whole city is constantly changing, you can stay any number of days in Varanasi, your life will not be same. In other places, you should not stay more than 3 days, so that it is just, if this instruction is given, so that you don't settle down. Settling down stops your growth. With a living master, you can never settle down. In Varanasi, you can stay as long as you want because it will never let you settle down. Once in every 3 days, the whole city will be different. In Bidadi, every day city is different. One day you get the rose, one day you get the Trishul. One day you get the lotus. One day you do Guru Puja, Next day, Guru does puja to you. It's exchange of puja. And what not? Anyhow, understand. The basic truth, everything is centered on consciousness. I am asking all my disciples, don't even cherish the idea you are my disciple. When I say this, I mean, then don't cherish any other relationship other than you being consciousness. See, the last relationship you need to break is the idea you are a disciple of me. When I say even break that, it means I am asking you to break everything else and then break this. People try to break this first and then try to break everything else. No, that is not possible. Break everything else and then come and break this also. Remain only with one clarity. I am a pure consciousness. So my responsibility, my being, my nature, my space, my action, my result, everything is centered in that consciousness, belongs to that consciousness. Just me surrendering to consciousness is enough to change anything I want as I want. It is consciousness that is life. That is result. Touch with the consciousness can be million, million, million times beautiful, amazing, fulfilling than any pleasure, any fruit of life you are expecting. So decide to cognize yourself as pure consciousness. I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Advaita, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetam, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss